So sleep apnea can absolutely be deadly, and there are many different ways that sleep apnea can be deadly. Sleep apnea is associated with heart attacks, with strokes, with congestive heart failure. All of those can have a very detrimental impact and be lethal. The primary risk is that these terrible consequences that we've discussed become more and more likely as we go longer and longer periods of time without treating the obstructive sleep apnea. So we're much more likely to develop congestive heart failure, to develop uncontrolled hypertension, to have a heart attack or a stroke, and to be excessively sleepy and suffer some complication of the excessive sleepiness, like a motor vehicle accident or an industrial accident. So we look at the severity of sleep apnea with what's called the apnea hypopnea index. And that's just an average of number of times an hour that breathing is inadequate to the point that our oxygen level drops and it interrupts our brain waves. All of us stop breathing every now and then while we're asleep. So an apnea hypopnea index of less than 5 is actually normal. We grade obstructive sleep apnea as mild, moderate, or severe based on the value of the apnea hypopnea index. So 5 to 15 is mild, 15 to 30 is moderate, and above 30 is severe obstructive sleep apnea.